crashing through the lies and disinformation. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
My friends, it is the 30th day of June 2013. I am your host, Alex Jones, and we are going to be live here for the next 2 hours, as we are every single Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central, back weekdays, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. Wayne Madsen is going to be joining us in the second hour for three of the segments. Wayne did work at the National Security Agency. He's testified to Congress before about illegal spying over a decade ago. And Wayne was in a big London Guardian article yesterday that got pulled from The Guardian and The Observer, one of the biggest group of publications in the UK. It got pulled. And then at the same time, they even went into the Google system, which I've never seen before, and took it out of the Google Wayback Machine. In fact, if we punch up my middle computer, folks can see it there if you're watching on prisonplanet.tv or infowars.com/show. We now offer the radio show free to everybody while we can pay for the bandwidth. Then subscribers get the nightly news and all the films, the rest of it. Our goal is just to get the word out, period. And that's why we're putting that out, so people can actually see it if you're a radio listener. But shocking NSA scoop on Saturday. The Guardian revealed a major NSA scoop, then deleted it from their website. I saw this in the Business Insider this morning, posted up on Infowars.com, so I called Wayne. And on his site, he has it archived, but other than that, it's gone. You click on the Google Wayback Machine, and I actually searched the article headline in a fresh search of their site. I clicked on this morning, and it was there. It's now gone, ladies and gentlemen. That's the type of stuff that is going on. Now, continuing here, look at it. There's the Wayne Madsen right there, revealed secret European deals to hand over private data to America. This has been known forever. Like, this has been declassified over and over again, that is called Infopol 9, basically, over Europe. And it's the same grid. And they all share. And Europeans can then listen to us. So, see, the Europeans are out in the press going, how dare America? We would never put up with this. I saw an article 2 years ago where a guy was in France, and he said, man, this is the bomb going to this sporting event. And he was arrested. And then you've seen examples of Europeans coming over here and others saying, man, we're coming to America to tear the place down. And here comes the FBI. They're reading the emails, the text, listening. That is on record. They're only going after Snowden and people because they're saying it's morally wrong. So they're really going after their free speech. They're going after Greenwald's speech, interviewing somebody like Snowden and having David Gregory on NBC say arrest him. And it is disgusting. So there it is, revealed secret European deals to hand over private data to America. That's up on Infowars.com. And then we're linked to a new article to Wayne Madsen putting out a report today responding to all this. It is a big deal. You know, we tend to have Wayne on so much every few months. People think, oh, that's just Wayne Madsen. Folks, he worked at the NSA. He worked before that in Navy security. And he worked in the Naval War College. And he has testified to Congress, and he has the sources. And he's just, but he's going after a European commission that admitted it a decade ago. And James Bamford's book, 12 years ago, Body of Secrets, had exposed Operation Northwoods, among other things. So he'll be joining us. We've got all the other news first, though. We've got reports out there right now that they're planning massive rioting. Boy, did that story go mega viral. Folks are planning that if Zimmermann doesn't get convicted. We'll be covering that and a lot more. Stay with us.
there is an increased need to support our immunity and health. At Silver Lungs, we are committed to meeting your needs by providing a full selection of silver-based products. Our most popular silver-based products are the 32-ounce nano silver solutions, our 2-ounce nano silver nasal applicators, as well as our all-natural silver soaps. Just released is our 100% natural silver gel. Our new silver gel is not based on synthetic gelling agents, which quickly evaporate and leave the silver at the surface. But rather, we have formulated our silver gel using the natural skin nourishing chemistry of aloe vera to quickly penetrate and nourish the skin, while delivering the silver more effectively. Visit www.silverlungs.com and click on our store page to find what silver-based products are best for you. That's www.silverlungs.com.
We've got it.
This transmission is coming to you.
Waging war on corruption.
All right, you are a go.
It's Alex Jones coming to you live from the front lines of the info war.
Waging war on corruption, crashing the lies and disinformation. I'm your host, Alex Jones, and we're live the 30th day of June, this Sunday, 2013, and we've got a very important pro-liberty transmission jam-packed with truth and decisive research coming up, so stay with us. Again, folks, coming up in the second hour, a real NSA insider whistleblower will be joining us, Wayne Madsen. A big cover story in the London Guardian / Observer came out yesterday and was denoticed by the British government. They have national security declarations over there where they can shut the press down. Very authoritarian. Under the so-called U.S. government request, they have been slapping down scores of mainstream media reports about illegal spying and how Europe and the U.K. is working with the criminals that run our government to engage in this type of activity. And Wayne Madsen's story that was up on The Guardian, there was not a retraction, there was not anything. It went out in the print edition of the newspaper nationwide and into Europe. It's one of the biggest English-speaking papers in Europe, if not the biggest. It went out, but they removed it off of the online. And we have screenshots of it at the bottom of the article on Infowars.com. They removed it, and now they have removed it from the Google cache system. That I've never seen Google remove something from its cache. So that has all been disappeared, and we have links to that you can see up on Infowars.com. And exclusively, Wayne Madsen will be joining us. He's talked to the newspaper. It was the government, quote, putting pressure on them to remove it. But as Madsen pointed out over the phone, I said, well, wait, the stuff you talk about, you're smart. Like Dr. Bob Bowman, the former head of the Star Wars program, the weaponized space system, before that Colonel Bowman in the Air Force, you're smart, like that engineer and nuclear physicist Bob Bowman. He'll come on and talk about space weapons, but only what's been accidentally leaked by other people. Only what's been gotten out by the press in the past, he can come out and say what's accurate and what isn't. And he talked about on C-SPAN debating the current head of the Star Wars program in the late 80s. And the guy got real angry with him and started releasing a bunch of classified stuff. And so he was then able to talk about that because his former colleague got angry and was blurting it out. And the truth is, it's like General Petraeus as the head of the CIA last year, now defrocked, disgraced, kicked out in one of those interagency wars, was at a technology conference put on by Wired Magazine. And he said, look, we got wireless internet looking through your walls. He said, look, all your new appliances have microphones, cameras, your dishwasher's watching you. And of course, we're listening to everything you're doing. But it's for your safety. So because he was promoting it from a perspective of this spying illegally is good for you and to keep you safe from the bad men, like we're 2 years old and really believe these fairy tales, then you don't go to jail. But if you're Edward Snowden and you come out and you say, hey, they're spying on everybody illegally, these are the programs that are in place, and I think it's terrible and I can't go on living like this anymore, then they've got to call you a traitor and an enemy and a piece of trash and say you've endangered America and get all sycophantic about national security when the globalists are the ones destroying our industry, our sovereignty, and our security. So I'm going to talk to the people out there like David Gregory of Meet the Press, who with extreme salivation had Greenwald of The Guardian on last Sunday and said, hey, you ought to be arrested. We played the clip last Sunday. You ought to be arrested. You know, maybe you should be arrested. And I mean, this is so outrageous. The spying is illegal on record without warrants. This is part of the war on journalists. They're using the NSA on the Associated Press and on Fox News. They're arresting members of the State Department that talk to Fox News or to this show, for that matter. People go to the State Department, to the cafeteria, meet with them and go, what's your view as a top analyst on North Korea? Are they capable of, you think, really launching a nuclear weapon at Japan? Well, yes, we think they're crazy enough. They are unstable enough to do it. And we don't think they're planning to, but they are dangerous. And we believe they have three weapons. I mean, that's in the newspaper. And they went and arrested that guy and are talking about charging the Fox News head national security reporter. I mean, that was in the news a month ago. And then they take Snowden. There's a bunch of whistleblowers. There's been AT&T, NSA whistleblowers. There's been a ton of them. James Bamford interviewed a bunch of whistleblowers and brought out more than Snowden did 12 years ago in Body of Secrets. We interviewed him. And mainly what he did was go and dig through the National Security Archives and then go and talk to retired people about what they could tell them about things in the archives. And mainly it was our so-called government shipping narcotics around the world, our so-called government running sex slavery, white slavery, our so-called government staging terror attacks to blame foreign governments and take American liberty. That came out in ABC News, by the way. James Bamford used to be the producer, the news director of Nightline. Oh, you didn't know they've declassified over 200 instances of the U.S. Army blowing stuff up to blame an enemy. I mean, this, and our military says, well, we do this because other people do. Yeah, I guess other people do. Operation Himmler was more than a dozen staged terror attacks to be blamed on Poland and countries like that to start World War II. I guess Operation Himmler did really work well for a while. So this is the type of stuff I deal with and that we all deal with when we're informed, is hearing other talk show hosts literally salivate on air going, Richard Snowden or Edward Snowden is a traitor and all these people need to be arrested and we need to go after them and we need to go after people that try to hurt America and all this business. He didn't give out ICBM information. He didn't give out cruise missile information. He didn't give out how many knots an aircraft carrier can move, or steam, as they call it, even though it's nuclear-powered, they call it steam. I guess they call it cruise now. He didn't give out the classified speed of an Abrams M1A1 tank. They didn't give any of that out. He came out and said, we are spying on everybody, in the middle of a huge scandal where they were caught spying on the press and caught spying on the House cloakroom and the Senate cloakroom, where people go to eat their lunch. The Justice Department has stinking microphones planted in there. Totally illegal.